In this segment, we're going to talk about an example of improper integration. How do we numerically solve improper integrals? And in this example, we're looking at singular integrands. So this example is corresponding to integrands which are singular. So the example which we want to solve the integral for is given as this. So in this case, what you're already finding out is that x equal to 3, the integrand is going to infinity. So, but this integral is finite, so far as the integral is concerned, but the integrand is infinite at x equal to 3. And we want to be able to find the approximate value. In the previous example, we used the two-point Gauss quadrature rule. So in this case, we still want to use two-point Gauss quadrature rule, but over two equidistant segments. What I mean by that is that in the previous example, we took two-point Gauss quadrature rule, applied it from 0 to 3, and found the value of this integral. In this example, what you're asked to do is, because we've got about a very large percentage error of about, 25%, we are thinking that maybe what we should do is break this interval into two equidistant segments and then apply two-point Gauss quadrature rule over each of those segments. So basically, we'll have four quadrature points, but we're going to break it up into two equidistant segments and apply the two-point Gauss quadrature rule over each segment and see that whether we get a better approximation. So in this case, what we are trying to do is we are taking the integral going from 0 to 3, 5x divided by square root of 9 minus x squared dx. We're going to break it up from 0 to 1.5, 5x divided by square root of 9 minus x squared dx. And then the next one, we're going to take from 1.5 to 3, 5x divided by square root of 9 minus x squared dx. We're going to apply the two-point Gauss quadrature rule on this integral. We're going to apply the two-point Gauss quadrature rule on that integral and see that what we get from there. So I'm going to skip some steps because we have been showing these steps for every for many cases in Gauss quadrature and also in the previous example for this one. That the first thing which we have to do is that we have to convert the integral going from A to B to an integral going from minus 1 to plus 1 to be able to apply the two-point Gauss quadrature rule formula, which is given by this formula right here. So this is how you are able to convert any integral going from any definite integral with finite limits of integration to integral with going from to minus 1 and plus 1. And also, we also know that the integral from minus 1 to plus 1 f of x dx is approximated by the two-point Gauss quadrature rule by this particular formula here, where c1 is 1, c2 is 1, x1 is minus 0.5773, and x2 is 0.5773, plus 0.5773. So we're going to apply these two formulas. So first, we're going to convert it into an integral going from minus 1 to plus 1, and then we're going to apply this approximation of this two-point Gauss quadrature rule for each of those integrals. So you might think that I'm skipping steps here as I'm going to show you the next step. It's mainly because we have covered this in the previous example and also in the examples in the Gauss quadrature rule, which you are more than welcome to see. So the first integral is basically going to become 0.75, the integral going from minus 1 to plus 1, f of 0.75 x plus 0.75 times dx. And the other one is going to become b minus a divided by 2, which will be 0.75 also, but the integrand will have the arguments of 0.75x plus 2.25 dx. So what that means is that this is the change which we are doing to convert these integrals from 0 to 1.5 is this integral, and from 1.5 to 3 is this integral here. So that we can apply the Gaussian quadrature formula. So this